It's about the other end of the spectrum. We started at families. The other end is too big to fail.
Right.
Until we build a Chapter 11 system, a resolution authority system, whatever we want to call this, until we build the part of the legal structure that permits us as a people to say with real credibility behind it, credibility is the underlined word here, I don't care what your business is. I don't care how big you are, I don't care how intertwined you are. If you make bad enough decisions, you can be liquidated. It's over.
The three people who made the decisions during the Bush administration, Bernanke, Geithner at the New York Fed, and Paulson at Treasury, on balance, worked 24/7 and did the best they come. And as Warren Buffett said, it would have been better. I worry if somebody else had been in those jobs. Then you had Larry Summers comes in, you have Geithner at Treasury, Bernanke continues. Do you believe they did as good a job as a lot of people have sat at this table and said, considering the circumstances, they did a good job?
I think, given their worldview, that they did a good job. And ultimately, look, I want to give full credit. The TARP, extraordinarily unpopular for very good reasons. The bailout of AIG, that's right, bailing out the banks, bailing out AIG, ultimately bailing out the auto companies. There are a lot of people who are unhappy about many parts of that.
And would you have done that?
They pulled us back from the abyss, and I believe that. But there are two central questions. Did you pull back in a way that was all about preserving those specific institutions, or did you pull back in a way that was ultimately about preserving the larger economy, about thinking about families, about thinking about the cost? Let me say this differently.
Okay, as a Chapter 11 lawyer.
Right. No, there's a key part to this on bailing out the banks. Here's what's always driven me crazy about this from the beginning. I understand financing that comes in once a business is in distress. We call it post-petition financing in the bankruptcy world. The price for that is that equity gets wiped out, top management loses their jobs, and the old debt takes a haircut of some proportion. Mm-hmm. To come in and rescue under those circumstances, I get it. That happens. That's what bankruptcy is about. That says the participants in the old one don't get it. What we did when we rescued these banks is that we left the shareholders intact, we left their top management intact, we paid their debt in full. We came in and
so
supported
the U.S. government, in your judgment,
is.
For good motivation, mostly to save the economy from collapsing, made a bad deal.
We were
for the United States
too generous.
That's a bad deal, isn't it?
With those who had made
so you could have
mistakes.
Saved the economy without going to the extent and making the deal you did.
I think you could have.
And within the context of the crisis at the moment and working around the clock.
Come on. Bankruptcy lawyers work around the clock all the time. You do it
all right,
with
so you don't
lots
buy that.
Of
you don't, you don't
I'm
get,
sorry.
All right.
We do it with lots of large financial institutions.
Okay.
Wiping out shareholders who were the people who invested and who had profited from all of the mistakes that these companies had made for years and years and years before that, that's not hard. That's not rocket science. That's just a difference on who gets to sit at the table and who gets to walk away with money. I'm sorry. That one is not an emergency situation.
Okay, so if you had been in charge of doing this.
Well, but I wasn't.
No, I know. Yes, you weren't. But you would have done what? You would have saved Lehman?
You can save the business, what's moving, and I understand why we had to save it for the economy. You can also send a very strong signal to markets. We are going to back up our financial institutions. But that doesn't
mean...
There's
no moral hazard here. We're going to back up our financial institutions.
That's right. But listen to it, because that is the key to moral hazard. But those who invested in these institutions before this moment have to... They got the profits. They now have to take the pain associated with that.